Hi everyone, this is Vitasa and welcome to my channel. In today's video, we will make New Year resolutions that we can actually follow. First of all, congratulations to us for surviving another year, by the way. It was a really hard one, right? Anyway, I'm a very cliche person and just like everyone else, I tend to make plenty of resolutions before a new year, only to drop them or forget about them in like a few weeks. That's because most of our resolutions are really hard to follow because we aim very high and circumstances are not always in our favor. For example, I promised to travel all year in 2020 and we all know how that went. And this year I wanted to lose at least 7 kgs and let's say I am not even close. Some resolutions are too unrealistic even for ourselves, hence we unknowingly drop them and give up along the way. So I have thought that instead of making big promises, we must start with smaller things that can easily fit into our lives until they become a habit and make other things easier for us. Also, this whole thing is not only for you, it's for me as well. And we are doing this together so that whatever our year is like, we at least have our shit together in 2022. So let's go. So the first thing I really want to do is start waking up early. Yeah, very cliche, but hear me out. If you're anything like me, you love to sleep and don't even realize how much time you already waste snoozing away your morning alarm. Have you ever wondered how much stuff you can get done in the 5 minutes that turn to 30, 40 or even 60 minutes in my case? With that extra time on my hand, I can do exercise, skincare, play with my cats, eat breakfast at a normal time, start a new series, cry about my life and find a cure for COVID. Make it a habit to set your alarm 10 minutes earlier than the time you usually get up and try to wake up around that time. This is where you will have to force yourself for a couple days and then when you're used to it, set it 10 minutes even earlier and so on. Keep doing it until you reach your desired time and get used to waking up really nice and early. Most of us get up late because we sleep late, so if you're having trouble sleeping earlier, replace scrolling your phone with an activity you find boring. For me, reading a book immediately puts me to sleep. So try revising a chapter or doing your assignment before sleeping or watch a very boring documentary about inflation or something and try not to take any naps during the day, by the way. Once you're a morning person, you'll start noticing how much time you actually have in your hands and you will find out why morning people are always so cheerful and happy. They have this strange energy around them that now we will also have. The next thing I really want to do is meditate. I cannot physically stress this enough as to how important it is to meditate, especially in these times when our mental health issues are soaring high. Meditation has helped me so much in the past year to get clarity, relief my anxiety and help me focus. I somehow stopped doing it regularly because, you know, I'm a piece of shit. But I'll try to get back and make it a habit once again and you are doing it with me. If it's something new for you, you'll find plenty of playlists to meditate on YouTube and Spotify. Look for 5-minute meditations and as we will be waking up early, let's put this one right after waking up to give your day a very positive start. You can increase these 5 minutes to 10 and then 15 if you feel your focus is increasing and you have enough time in the day. This little routine will bring so much clarity in your life and you'll start noticing change in everything you do. Now that you are more focused, you'll feel lighter and even a little bit more happier. Clean your room or surroundings. Having my room organized literally solves half of my problems and makes me think that I have some kind of control. Don't wait until it's unbearable to look at, and messy rooms are really distracting. Keep cleaning up soon after you're finished with the task. Take out like 5 minutes from your day to make your bed when you wake up. Clean your desk when you're done working. Keep your clothes back in their place. Fold your laundry immediately and just keep everything in their place. This is something that I'm trying since a few weeks and honestly, it makes me think that I have my life together. If you do that, this will not only save you a lot of hard work for later, but it will also keep your mind stress-free and more focused on important things now that you don't have to clean up like a whole room. something you should start doing in 2022 is start journaling your exciting and not so exciting days. And it doesn't have to be those beautifully organized journals with, you know, drawings and flowers, because honestly, I personally can't do it even if I try. But I journal a lot, and that means I write down whenever I'm confused, sad, happy, or I need to distract myself. Writing helps me articulate my thoughts and feelings and look at them from a different perspective. I even find solutions to my problems while I'm writing about it. You can also include your daily, weekly plans and make extensive to-do lists, or just note down memorable events in your diary, and once you get used to it, your journal will be your comfort and companion forever. This is my one habit that I absolutely love, and I love going back to my old pages to see how far I've come and how everything becomes okay at some point. Now, the last resolution is kind of a misfit but super important for your mental health. Say no when you want to. Most of us are conditioned to be people pleasers and polite and think about others even if it's not good for us. The past 2 years might have made me a little cold and deprived of a lot of feelings, but you don't owe people anything, unless, of course, you do owe them like a favor or money. In that case, return the favor and money. But otherwise, you have to learn to take a stand for yourself. You only have to cross that one border of being honest, and that is going to save you a lot of mental turmoil later. It's very important to listen to your heart and look for your own comfort instead of just agreeing to everything the other person says. It doesn't make you a bad person. Just say no when you want to say it. In fact, if you don't want to listen to me right now, just say no. I'm kidding, obviously. And that's it, everyone. These 5 things are so simple and seem trivial, but honestly will make a humongous difference in your lifestyle and help you have more control over your life. And if you have more control, then you can actually have time and focus to do other important stuff. Also, it's okay if you don't follow a routine someday and your life still seems like a mess. It's completely okay to not have it together sometimes. It's okay to have bad days. Remember, you can always totally turn it around whenever you want to and whenever you feel like. If you're with me in this journey, leave a like on the video and don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and let's get back a year later to see how we did. Thank you so much for watching. I am so grateful for you all. Happy New Year, and I'll see you soon. Bye.